execution, and we took a lot of problems based on that. So today I'm going to introduce many other new types of integration. There are many types which will be exploring in today's class. So I'm going to start with integration of the type sine to the power mx cos to the power nx, where m and n are natural numbers. So first I'm going to start with case 1, where m is even and n is an odd natural number.
So how does that matter since it's odd? What changes?
It matters, the approach changes a bit. We are using method of substitution only here, but the choice of the function whom we are substituting as our variable will change depending upon the power. Okay. Let me take an example. Let's say sine to the power 4x cos cubex. Okay. Now in such a scenario, the function which is subjected to the even power, which is sine in this case, that would be taken as the variable t. So we'll take sine x as t. So obviously cos x dx will become dt. Right? So what will you do? Okay. So when you substitute here, you can substitute sine x as t, so t to the power 4. Cos square can be substituted as 1 minus sine square, which is 1 minus t square. And cos x dx will become dt.
Just open up the brackets.
Okay. Now just open up the brackets, it will become t to the power 4 minus t to the power 6 dt, which can be integrated as t to the power 5 by 5 minus t to the power 7 by 7 plus t. Substitute your t back as sine. So in this algorithm, you substitute the trigonometric ratio or trigonometric function with the even power as t.
So what would be the integral sine square?
We'll come to that. That will be a part of this.
So here you're saying that you can substitute any trigonometric function with an even power as they can sign.
So in this case, the one with the even power will be substituted. We're talking about this thing. So if cos is to the even power, then substitute cos st.
Yeah, then okay.
Yeah, let's take another example. Yeah, we are taking a type of integral of this form, where sine is raised to the power n, cos is raised to the power n, m and n are natural numbers. Now we are taking cases here, when m is even, n is odd. In fact, you can have also the case where n is even, m is odd. Indirectly, I am trying to say one should be even, one should be odd. Whichever is subjected to the even power, preferably, in fact, you should always substitute that function as t. So here sine is subjected to the even power, I'll substitute sine x as t. Try this one out. Sine to the power 3x cos to the power 6x. Tomorrow 10 to 1, this will be there. There will be two types of papers. One would be of higher level, another would be of CT level. So I would suggest the top 10 or 12 people or 13 people to write the advanced one and the rest to write the CT one. It's not like something will...
Wait, advanced?
Tomorrow is advanced level.
No. Papers are of JEE level only, but one is slightly of a higher level, one is slightly of a lower.
mains and advanced.
It's not necessarily both are mains level only, but a higher main and a lower main.
Sir, how did you handle the cos square?
I broke up sine cube, cos cube as cos square into cos. The reason was I wanted a cos x dx separated out so that it behaves as dt. So the moment I achieve this, this integral becomes quite easy to us for integration, right? This one?
Sir, one second, you split cos cube x into cos x dx, but you can take sin x as t and you can substitute t, right?
Yes.
We'll discuss it. Easier to solve.
Can I erase this one?
Yeah.
For this one, obviously, cos is subjected to the even power, so I would take cos x as t. Right? That means minus sin x dx is going to be dt. Right? Which means pull out a sin x from here. Okay? So it becomes sin square x cos to the power 6x into sin x dx, which I can easily substitute as minus dt. So this integral becomes 1 minus t square t to the power 6 into minus dt. So you can write it as t to the power 8 minus t to the power 6 dt, t to the power 9 minus t to the power 7 by 7 plus c. Put your t back as cos x. Pretty simple. Next we'll take case number 2 when both are odd. Now we'll talk of case number 2. Case number 2 where both m and n are odd. Okay. Now in such a case you can substitute any one of sine and cos as your t, but preferably you should substitute that as t. Substitute that trigonometric function as t which has greater power. Take for example integral of sine cube x cos to the power 5x. Now I can substitute sin x also as t, cos x also as t, but since cos x is subjected to a higher power, I will substitute cos x as t. So minus sin x dx becomes dt, that is sin x dx becomes minus of dt. So what we will do, we will pull out a sin x from here. And start substituting, this becomes 1 minus t square, this becomes t to the power 5, this becomes minus dt, which easily converts to t to the power 7 minus t to the power 5 dt, whose integral is t to the power 8 by 8 minus t to the power 6 by 6 plus c. Substitute your t back as cos x, which gives you this answer. Here please remember you could have also substituted sin x as t, but in that case what would happen, you would pull out a cos x out and you would be left with cos to the power 4x, which you would have converted as cos square square, and cos square is 1 minus t square square. So unnecessarily you have to expand it and then continue the process of integration. Moving on to case number 3. Should I read this? Case number 3 is basically the case where both m and n are even. M and n both are even. Okay. Now in such cases, you will have to rely either on trigonometric identities or you can apply complex number method. Okay. That it can include whole numbers in. Let me take an example. Let's say I want to integrate sine square x into cos to the power 4x. Okay. So let me first apply trigonometric identities. While applying trigonometric identities, your aim should be to convert higher powers to higher angles. Correct?
So how you can subtract?
No. Here substitution will not work. It will work, but it will be leading to a very difficult integral.
You can write that sin square x as 1 minus cos square x.
Okay.
And then you have cos to the power 6x minus cos to the power 4x.
Okay.
And you can take cos x as t.
So what is going to happen is that the moment you start substituting any one of the trigonometric functions as t, you will experience irrational powers coming up, isn't it? So something like cos cube and all will be left off. So how do you write cos cube in terms of sine? So 1 minus t squared to the power of 3 by 2 and all will start coming up, which will make the integral more difficult to solve. So in such cases, you will have to rely on trigonometric identities, especially the ones which help you to convert higher powers to higher angles, right? For example, I am very well aware that sine square x could be written as 1 minus cos 2x by 2, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. And similarly, cos to the power 4x can be written as 1 plus cos 2x by 2 whole square, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. So basically, you can simplify this as 1 by 8. You have 1 minus cos square 2x into 1 plus cos 2x dx. Correct? Yes or no?
Yeah.
So this is sine square 2x. Sine square 2x can be written as 1 minus cos 4x by 2. Yes. So I can have 1 by 16 times this. Yeah, if you expand this, you'll have 1 plus cos 2x minus cos 4x and minus cos 4x cos 2x. Now, what is cos 4x into cos 2x? You can apply your transformation formula on this. Yes, sir. What is the formula of 2 cos A cos B? Cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. So we can apply the formula here. I can get 1 plus cos 2x minus cos 4x minus half cos 6x plus cos 2x. Yes, sir?
Okay.
Now, if you expand this, see, sine square, we all know that cos 2x is 1 minus 2 sine square x. So from here, sine square x could be written as 1 minus cos 2x by 2, which is what I did to the first term. Okay? Second term is cos square x whole square. And similarly, cos 2x formula identity we know is 2 cos square x minus 1. So cos square x could be written as 1 plus cos 2x by 2. So that is what I did over here with the whole square. Now 2 and 4 I took it out as 1 by 8 as of now. Okay. Then 1 plus cos 2x whole square and 1 minus cos 2x. I took out 1 from this and I made the formula a minus b a plus b, which became 1 minus cos square 2x. 1 minus cos square 2x is sin square 2x, and sin square 2x is again 1 minus cos 4x by 2. So the idea is the power has to be reduced to multiples of angles. The moment I start doing all these things, I would realize that I would have got rid of any multiple power. all of them have been converted to multiple angles now, which becomes pretty easy to integrate. So first let me just group the terms over here. This can be written as 1 plus half cos 2x, half cos 2x, and minus cos 4x minus half cos 6x. Correct? This is what I'll get. Now integrating this is a pretty easy task because we'll get x. This will be
sine
2x by 4. This will be minus sine 4x by 4. This will be minus sine 6x by plus. Is that okay?
So, sine to the power 5x,
cos square x, you basically take cos x as t. The one with the even power will be taken as t.
Sir,
so,
even one with the higher
power,
no even.
When both are odd, when one is even, another is odd, the one with the even power is taken as t. When both are odd, the one with the higher odd power is taken as t. Yes, Nikhil, you're asking.
It's 1 plus half cos 2x, right?
Yeah.
What are the minus sine 2x by 4?
Cos 2x integral is sine 2x by 2. Cos 2x derivative is minus sine 2x.
Sorry.
Is this idea clear? Is this clear in your mind? Now, there is a drawback of trigonometric identity method that when the power becomes heavy, it starts putting a lot of pressure because, let me take an example. So in school, please follow this method. However, I am going to tell you another method, which is the complex number method. Yeah. Oh, I am so sorry. 1 by 16 is going to be a thing. Sorry, I missed that. 1 by 16 is also there. Thanks. So now I am going to talk about those situations where trigonometric identities will be painful. Right? Mostly these two identities are very heavily used. Cos 2x is 1 minus 2 sin square x and 2 cos square x minus 1. Let's say I want to integrate cos to the power 10x. Okay. Sine I have not written, you can consider sine to the power 0x. Both are even. Now in this case, if you start applying trigonometric identities, you will of course have to write it as cos square x to the power 5. Cos square you have to write it as 1 plus cos 2x by 2 to the power 5. Expand it. My God.
What are you talking about,
sir? I'm talking about how to solve this by using trigonometric identities. So again, expanding 1 plus cos 2x to the power 5 itself will lead to 6 terms. Correct? And again, every power you need to again simplify it to a multiple angles. That would be a very, very painful task. It will be very time consuming as well. So when powers become very heavy, trigonometric identities starts giving way. So what we'll follow is something called the complex number method. In complex number method, what do we do? We have all learned that I can always represent this as a complex number z, right? Having the modulus as 1, argument as x. So by De Moivre, can I say 1 by x would be cos x minus I sin x? Correct? Yes or no? And z plus 1 by z would be 2 cos x?
Yeah, correct.
So can I say cos x can be written as half of this? Okay. Now I'm not doing integration using complex numbers. I'm just trying to simplify the term using complex numbers. Integration has still not started. Okay. Now if I ask you to raise this to the power of 10, that means you're raising this to the power of 10? Okay. Now, if I ask you expand z plus 1 by z to the power of 10, you can easily apply binomial expansion. Now, in binomial expansion, you would realize that you get z to the power 10 term and the last term would be 1 by z to the power 10. Correct? Next term would be 10z to the power 8 and the last term would be 1 10 by z to the power 8. Okay, you can expand it. Next term will be 10c2. What is 10c2? 45. So 45 z to the power 6, 1 by z to the power 6 plus next term would be 10c3. 10c3 is 120.
Yeah.
Correct? 10c3 is 10 into 9 into 8 by 6, which is 120. So 120 z to the power 4 plus 1 by z to the power 4. Correct? Next term would be, anybody who is feeling problem in understanding this, please raise your hand. Okay. So you all know the expansion of a plus b to the power n, right? Class 11th, you have done this. So what is the expansion? nc0 a to the power n, then nc1 a to the power n minus 1 b, nc2 a to the power n minus 2 b square, and it goes on till ncn a to the power 0, or you can say b to the power n directly, right? Now treat your n as 10, a as z and b as 1 by z. So what will be the first term? 10c0, which is what? 1. Z to the power 10, correct? The last term would be what? 10c10, 1 by z to the power 10. So what I am doing here, I am collecting the terms here. So this is the collection of the first and the last term. Next term would be 10c1, which is 10, z to the power 9 and 1 by z. Z to the power 9 into 1 by z will be z to the power 8. Similarly, the second last term would be nc n minus 1, a into b to the power n minus 1, correct?
Yeah.
So what will be that term? 10c9 z into 1 by z to the power of 9, which will be 10 into 1 by z to the power 8. So what I am doing is, I am collecting these two terms here. So the first term, the last term, I am grouping it. Second term, second last term, I am grouping it. Third term, third last term, I am grouping it. I will keep on doing like this. Now tell me, what will be the next term?
210 z square
plus 1 by z square. Right? 10c1, 10c2, 10c3, 10c4, 10c5. 10c5 is how much?
252.
252, that's it. Now you'll think, what benefit did I get by using all these things? The benefit is pretty clear. Can I use this?
So what if you have another term, sine to the power 11 x cos to the power
11 x?
Suppose I have sine to the power 12 x and cos to the
power 11 x. Very heavy terms will not come, but I will deal with that scenario.
And this is for only cos term.
This is only for when both the powers are even.
Yeah, but this question only causes.
I'm only taking cos for the purpose of explaining it. I'll take more examples. Can I erase this? This part at least. Now, what is the benefit of using this? If I ask you a simple question.
Yes, sir.
If z is this, what is z to the power 10?
The
you will say by d modulus it will be cos 10x plus I sin 10x. The argument gets multiplied to the 10.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. And what is 1 by z to the power 10? You would say cos 10x minus I sin 10x. So when you add them, you get 2 cos 10x. So the benefit of doing this is, you would realize the first term here would convert to 2 cos 10x. Is it a simple term to integrate?
Yeah.
Very simple. It becomes sine 10x by 10. Okay. Similarly, this would become 10 into 2 cos 8x. Easy to integrate? What would this become? 45 into 2 cos 6x.
Yeah, correct.
Again, easy to integrate. Next term would be 120 into 2 cos 4x. Next will be 210 into 2 cos 2x. and 252 will remain as 252. So this is finally my cos to the power 10x. So can I say integrating this is as good as integrating this?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. And this is far more easy to integrate. 1024. Yeah, this is 2 sine 10x by 10. This will be 20 sine 8x by 8. Yeah, this will be 90 sine 6x by 6. Then I'll have 240 sine 4x by 4. So 420 sine 2x by 2 and 252x plus. Okay. Now this is much more convenient than applying the trigonometric identities, trust me. Try doing the same problem by using trigonometric identities. You will get lost. It will be such a big expression that you will keep on correcting terms. Right? So here, complex number method in tandem with binomial theorem is helping us out. I know, you will not get such a big problem like this. But it's just to illustrate how useful can be the complex number method.